am a busy man, a busy individual. I'm the type of person who has a lot of irons in the fire, you might say. A real Renaissance man, a person who has a lot of interest in a lot of areas and a lot of proficiencies in a lot of areas of life. And I'm coming to you from the studio where we ordinarily tape my highly respected political commentary show, America's Evil Genius. But before I tape that show this week, I did want to take a moment out of my busy schedule to address some issues that were brought to light by none other than Mr. James E. Cornette. Good old Jim Cornette recently sent in a video from Castle Cornette out there in Louisville, Kentucky, otherwise known as his double-wide trailer by the side of the road, and he sends in this video making a lot of threats about me, a lot of threats towards me, Travis Cook. Well, I felt like I needed to address some of those here today. You see, there's a big event coming to East Carondolet, Illinois on Saturday night, December the 13th. The main event is Ricky Cruz with yours truly in his corner against Red River Jack, this mysterious masked man that nobody knows who it is, except everybody really knows who it is. It's Ron Powers. Ron Powers lost a Loser Leave Town match to Ricky Cruz several months earlier, and now he's come back under a mask. The oldest trick in the pro wrestling playbook, I'd like to remind you. And so we're going to have a match on December the 13th where when Ricky Cruz wins, that mask has to come off, and when we see it's Ron Powers, he's going to be gone for good. And not only is he going to be gone for good, but that's going to be a violation of contract on Herb Simmons' part, and that's going to set me up real well to sue the britches off him and take every penny he's got. I might just own Southern Illinois Championship Wrestling. But how does Jim Cornette play into all this? Well, it seems that Herb Simmons is sweating a little bit. It seems he's not real sure that Ron Powers, I mean Red River Jack, can keep his mask on. So he's gone out and gotten a special guest referee. He's brought in Jim Cornette to referee that important match. Now, Jim Cornette, when he sent that little interview down here, he sounded real tough. He sounded real bad. He sounded like, if I even make one move out of that seat, he'll slap me in the next week. That's what he'd like you to believe. But you see, Jim Cornette, in all of his bluster, in all of his talk, he left out a certain fact. He left out some very important points. He left out the fact that the last time he came to St. Louis, I'm the one who had his tennis racket in my hands. And I was this close to doing what people in the wrestling business have been trying to do for the better part of 30 years. I was this close to shutting Jim Cornette up for good. So yes, there's some animosity there, but there's also some fear on Jim Cornette's part. And so he's talking about having a special enforcer at ringside and doing all these kind of things to make sure I can't interfere in the match. What he's actually telling you is that he's scared to death I'm going to come in that ring and punch him in the jaw and end it all for good. But you see, old Jimmy, this is a no disqualification match. And if I decide to walk in that ring and punch your lights out, you can't disqualify me for it. Of course, you'll be knocked out anyway, so you couldn't do it anyhow. But there will be no repercussions. So you have unknowingly walked in to your demise. You've unknowingly walked into your situation where I'm going to get everything I want on December the 13th. Because Ricky Cruz is going to beat Red River Jack, rip the mask off, show it's Ron Powers. Then I'm going to sue Herb Simmons for everything he's got. I'm going to own Southern Illinois Championship Wrestling, and heck, I'll probably own the entire village of East Carondelet, Illinois, which I'll sell back to someone at a bargain basement price. And I will finally have the opportunity that I've been looking for 6 months to finally get some revenge on you, Jim Cornette, because you hit me from behind with a weapon. That's the only way you rednecks from Kentucky can fight anyway. Well, I know you came up watching Jackie Fargo and watching all these guys out in Tennessee and Kentucky that could fight and scrap and claw and do things dirty if they had to. But what you don't realize is that Travis Cook is a student of this game too, and I've watched all the same guys you have. I know all the dirty tricks you do. And believe me, I'm just waiting for you to get out of line December the 13th. I might not even wait for you to get out of line. Because in addition to taking that mask off of Ron Powers' ugly face and running him out of here, I am going to shut Jim Cornette up for good.